Now, live radar, this goes back the past 18 hours. You can see a couple of reports of severe weather with some lightning on Wilmington Island, also a tree down very close to Beaufort with some gusty winds. But look at all the lightning strikes that took place, mainly after, let's say, after 4:30. All those strikes along the coastal areas, mainly the islands yesterday, had heavy rain. Even the inland areas back toward south of Springfield and Effingham County, I know, had some heavy rain. But at least we're starting the morning out nice and dry. And the rainfall total yesterday for, say, this is Wilmington Island, where I have it highlighted right here, 2.9, very close to 3 inches, and it came down in probably less than 2 hours. And when you have that type of rainfall, it produces things like this on Johnny Mercer Boulevard that they had yesterday. Look at this here. And if you want to know exactly where this is, kind of easy to pick out. And you see the Shell gas station there off to the right, not in the picture. On the left side, we have the McDonald's, and right and front of this is the Kroger Shopping Center. Look at this tire right there, all the way up to above the tires. Boy, this is a great example here. Never drive through this standing water. It looks like that driver right there found out the hard way. And one good thing is we're going to see less sights of this today. I expect less chances of rain this afternoon. Already starting the day out nice and dry, showers and storms out over the coast. So your morning commute out the door for work will be a dry one. And future radar will show more in the way of sunshine later today, 11 o'clock, a mix of sun and clouds. After we get through some areas of dense fog for some of the inland areas to start the day, by 2 o'clock in the afternoon, we'll see some sunshine. And watch this. After 3, pop-up showers with daytime heat and humidity. Also into the early evening, we'll continue seeing just very isolated in nature. The coverage will be much less this afternoon. We had yesterday also showing a shower or even a thunderstorm moving through parts of Chatham County later this evening at 9 o'clock. Of course, we'll be tracking this for you in the tracking center later this afternoon, and definitely let everyone know if any of these storms do become severe with heavy rain. And would not be surprised with some of the storms that could have some heavy downpours. 8 o'clock this morning, starting out mostly cloudy, and then visibilities from Vidalia up to Statesboro, also in parts of Jasper County, reporting about a quarter of a mile to up to a half of a mile. So drive carefully through that area of dense fog. 88 degrees for highs, afternoon storms, and then 75 degrees at 9 o'clock, with a couple of thunderstorms probably dying out after about 9 o'clock. And the reason that we saw that unsettled weather yesterday, out ahead of a cold front, this front will finally push to our area over the next probably 24 to 36 hours. Once it pushes south, we're going to see some drier air working in, and I really reduced the chances of rain quite a bit for tomorrow. Now, Hurricane Edward, it did make it up to a major hurricane yesterday. Now it's down to 90 mile per hour winds, northeast, moving northeast at 20. This is going to do a little loop out here over the open Atlantic over the next several days, and not looking as well organized as it did yesterday. The eye is still visible, but boy, it was really a field really nicely yesterday. This is going to make that loop northeast and turning back to the maybe even south. Of course, we'll continue to track the tropics for you all the way through the end of hurricane season. Remember, hurricane season does not end until the end of November. Weekend forecast, coastal showers on Saturday and a little bit cooler. Look at that high, pleasantly 82, mid 80s on Sunday with a mix of sun and clouds. Now, I was talking about that chances of rain tomorrow, much less. 86 degrees, sun and clouds, scattered storms on Friday. And there's that weekend forecast once again with highs low to mid 80s.